If chemistry of your home, the science of your home is not in place, all is well.
Great.
Super. But when all is not well, as Dr. Subhash Kak was explaining, look at Einstein. Gave great contribution to this world. Because of his contribution, the world is in that way. So much he has given. But look at life. Last time, few years ago, when I came to give a lecture, there was a youth conference in Toronto University. After the lecture, we went back to the airport, same day, giving lecture to the youth, being very nice to them, and another youth. Now look at this tragedy. Same successful youth were talking about science and talking about their success and money and happiness and whatnot. And that first news I read in the paper, the Toronto Star news, I think that is Toronto Star. The front page news, one very famous psychiatrist of this country, all the time on TV, committed suicide, took her. Latest model of Mercedes, parked the car near the subway. Train was just about to come, took the baby and finished her life. Giving advice to all, to others. Every day, many were maybe inspired. But if you don't have that connection to yourself, to the divine, if that connection is broken, no matter what you do, what you achieve, all is vain. And the amazing part is, the sad part is, took the baby, finished her life and baby's life, and when they searched in the car, the CD was on in the car, maybe when she was coming in playing, "Don't Worry, Be Happy." "Don't Worry, Be Happy," the song was on. And still, she was not happy. Through your science is great. Nothing wrong in its science. Because of this science, we have these inventions, we have these great discoveries. Science is great. Our philosophy, our spirituality is not there to negate anything or to condemn anything. It always appreciates all parts of life. Everything is needed, but has its own place. Your internet can take you. What's this? LDSM? DSM. This DSM. Now they have broadband, so many new inventions can take you to the world. The fastest connection you have today available takes you to the world. But you need another net. Internet is great, you need it. Look at your iPod and all these inventions. Beautiful in one small piece of plate. You have everything. Listening to beautiful songs, watching movies, reading books, and whatnot. Facebook and Twitter, everything you want. Everything is available. It's wonderful. Have those inventions. Spirituality never negates them, condemns them. But at the same time, my dear, if you want to be happy, not only successful, people are successful today. I have met so many successful people on this earth. Meet every day. What is the definition of that success? Having money? Having joy? Having satisfaction? Having enjoyment? And those enjoyments are not permanent. In the Shastra it says, Santushta Satatam Yogi. Santushta. Who is Santushta? Who is content. Ever happy. Must. You ask those people who were sitting in the mountains. I was very little when I went to the mountains. Saw those saints with my naked eyes, being a baby, nothing was available there. They were sitting in the caves in the mountains and no menu for tomorrow. What to eat? What to plan? Nothing was available. So much in ecstasy, always feel I have no hangover, no problem. Whenever you ask them, how are you? Wonderful, super, super. Santushta. When you feel Santushta, then only. And that stage of Santushta comes through spirituality. Only then you can stay calm. Dr. Subhash was explaining when he concluded his remarks, thank goodness. Yes, you can be calm, you can be composed, you can be connected only when you are grounded, you are sent with that inner net. You need that inner net to embrace the world, to reach the world, to be one with the world. No matter what you have, my dear, end of the day, when things are shaken, things are broken, and in those moments, even the scientists, as he explained, and many others like him, lose all that science. Forget all that science. The true science is, the true science of life is, those moments you are not shaken. Things will go up and down. It's not that when you come to the temple and these spiritual things will not go up and down. Even the prophets came on this earth, the Krishna and the Ram Bhagavan came on this earth, even in their lives also. That was the lesson. That was the lesson to take from them. Even in their lives, things went up and down. They never went up and down. Prasannatam yagata visheta. So much is there to that. Smile, that muskan was not lost. That comes through spirituality, that comes through that spiritual connection, lost. I went to Australia. One lady came to see me and started complaining and giving the list, everything is wrong, and now I have come to the end that every night before I sleep, doctor has prescribed me tablets to eat. First I started with one, now two, now three, now four, I don't know where to end, and I'm tired of it. Swamiji, please tell me what I should do. I said, what you did? She gave me the name of the tablet. And that's what happens when you go to the doctor, go to the science. All this science is going to give you the tablet. Eat this tablet, eat that tablet, you will be okay. But now with the tablets, now she is there, went to the doctor, still she is so restless, cannot sleep in the night and falling apart. All of his life is so much in pain. She said, just request to the divine that takes me away from you. I don't want to live. I said, no mother, do one thing. I am not a doctor, I can't give you the medicine. Another medicine, you change your prescriptions, go to the medicine store, and go to the pharmacy, and take this tablet. I can only tell you one thing, what you take every day? She said, compose. In India, it's a very famous tablet. When people can't sleep, they are restless, they give you compose. I said, to me, I can suggest you only one thing, stop this medicine. She said, what? But it will be horrible. I will not be able to sleep. I said, just if you have come to take my advice, I will give you this advice. Stop this medicine. No compose from today. Done. Over. She said, but what next? I said, just calm your pose. Calm your pose. We are very expert. Pose our calm. We are not calm. We are not in peace within ourselves. But when we go to the clubs, in the pubs, in the parties, in the ceremonies, we pose our calm. Spirituality teaches you not to pose your calm, but calm your pose. For that, every day, three things. Number one, three multivitamins. Okay, now we are talking about the vibe. Tablets, let me give you three tablets. Number one, these three multivitamins every day. Number one, meditation in the morning, one pill. Number two, no reaction during the daytime. And number three, introspection before you sleep.